Thank you. All right. What you saw was a three-way shootout between my RGT EX 86100, the RGT EX 86110, and a TRX4. In that order, we had the RGT EX 86100, and it did valiantly because it was semi-broke. To come clean a little bit on my secret sauce, I've been trying to put a Red Cat Gen 8 diff in the front to get overdrive. I actually have one here, and as you can see, with the two diff plates, they semi look similar, and I got a diff with the overdrives, and with a little bit of grinding, I've got it to go in. It's slightly larger, but with a Dremel, you can get it to fit. But the gear mesh wasn't quite right. And in the process of me testing that diff, I kind of blew up the bearing that holds the pinion in the axle and helps the gear mesh. And that might be why you heard the clicking and saw the jittering that it had. But other than that, the truck did valiantly. It made it up the hill all the way. With the 86110, it did awesome. Best I've seen up that hill. That part of the park is a torture test. And other than it falling 30 foot down a hill, I didn't have any problems with that truck. It did break. The link mount broke. And the issue with that is on the 100, the link mounts are mounted inside the link mounts. On the 110, they're moved to the inside with a pivot ball inside the link mounts. If you take those out and move them back inside the link mounts, I don't think you'll have any trouble. I mean, I fell down that 30 feet again with it moved and didn't have any problems. I stole the link mount from the 86100, so that might be a little while to get a part to get it back up and running, but I'm a patient man. The TRX4, it is a Blazer chassis with sport running gear on it. And it has the Canyon Trail tires that didn't do too well up the wet hill. I mean, the foams were shot in them too, but I tried to keep this as apples to apples between all three of them. I mean, excluding the 86100. I've done quite a bit to that, but I was trying to keep it as apples to apples as possible, and with those tires and with the setup, it did quite well. I mean, it has the TRX4 problems. It's top heavy. It wants to flip back when it gets too steep, but as you've seen with the 110, it didn't have very many of those problems. I mean, I can put weight in the front of the TRX4. I can put a lower CG battery tray in it, which I actually have 3D printed. But this is a stock comparison. This is, I mean, as close to stock out of the box as you can get between those two. Well, that concludes this. I hope everyone out there is staying safe, staying well, staying sane. Here where I'm at, we are starting to ease restrictions, and hopefully that means I'll start to get to see more people out on the trail and doing what we love within this hobby. So well wishes to everyone, and thank you for watching.